Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 15 is just a month away from being shown to the public for the first time. And on June 7th, 2021, today is May 7th, 2021, on June 7th, Apple will start off the Worldwide Developer Conference with a keynote where they'll have a presentation showing iOS 15, iPadOS 15, most likely watchOS 8, tvOS 15, HomePodOS 15, and macOS 12, or whatever they decide to call that. At 1 p.m. Eastern, 10 a.m. Pacific, they'll have that keynote, go through all of the features or the major features and changes. And lately, there's been some information about those features, some leaks from reliable sources, such as Mark Gurman, for example. And I wanted to talk about those, as well as current supported devices, at least that's expected at this point, and then when you can expect the betas and the final release as well. Now, the first thing is the supported devices. A lot of people are messaging me saying, will my device support iOS 15? And we won't know that 100% until June 7th. However, current information says that Apple will drop support for the iPhone 6S and 6S Plus, as well as possibly the SE, but we don't know that for sure. That would mean that anything from the iPhone 7 or newer will be supported. Now, this could change. They could drop support for the iPhone 7. They could drop support for other phones as well, but it looks like that's what's going to take place. Also on the iPad side, they could drop support for the iPad Air 2, the iPad Mini 4, and iPad 5th generation. That just gives us the iPad Mini 5th generation all the way up to the iPad Pro 12.9 from 2021 that's set to launch pretty soon. So all of those devices could gain support and continue to use iOS 15 or whatever features it might have. Now, as far as features that we expect, I have some great concepts I'm going to show you from Angelo Libero. He allowed me to share these with you, so I'll link those in the description, but all the concepts I'll show of the device features and things, they're from him. Now, the first thing is that's expected to change is notifications. Now, notifications, some people love notifications in iOS, some people don't. But notifications is said to get a little bit of an overhaul with settings. So currently you have the option for notifications to send an auto reply if you're driving a car. Do not disturb while driving a car, for example. So you can have it auto turned on when you're actually driving a car and then reply with a message saying I'm driving with do not disturb. I'll message you later, something like that. The upcoming iOS 15 version is said to have a new menu that allows users to select if maybe they're driving, sleeping, working, or even having custom categories of their choosing. Now, this is according to Mark Gurman of Bloomberg. The menu will also be shown on an updated lock screen and control center, according to him. So that's possible. He's been pretty accurate with these in the past. So we could have all sorts of customizable notifications as they come in with auto replies, which would be great. Maybe you're working on something. You could have a work notification. You could have a home notification. Those sort of customizations would be great to see. Now, the next thing is iMessage. Now, this may or may not be coming to iOS 15, but apparently the eventual goal is to actually act more like WhatsApp or Facebook's social media network, but within iMessage. And it would sort of have auto replies, more customization. And if we go into iMessage, we'd be able to better customize how it looks, maybe have better group conversations than we do now, and much more. I can't wait to see what Apple has in mind with this, but this may come a little bit later, maybe not with iOS 15, but maybe a later update, 15.1. But we'll have to wait and see. Also, Apple is known obviously for privacy, and they're continuing to work on this. With iOS 15, it's said that privacy will get more options. So right now we have app tracking transparency, where we can block apps from tracking and getting information and sharing it with another app, such as Instagram or Facebook or more. But Apple is apparently going to give more privacy protections that would feature a new menu to show users which apps are silently collecting data as well. So not only tracking you, but collecting your data maybe to harvest that and sell within their own app. So it would give more information with that. I think that's great. Data is yours. It should be allowed to be controlled by you and nobody else. So I think that's a great move from Apple. So I think we'll see something like that. Now, multiple sources keep saying we're going to have an always-on display on at least iPhone 13. Now, the first concept shows kind of what this could look like with different notifications, or what a home screen altogether could look like with different notifications. So maybe some widgets like this with some different notifications across the top. It's just an idea, but it could look something like this, and maybe fade to black and white with an always on display, giving you time and date. So we'll have to wait and see if they actually do that. I would love to see it. It's very helpful on things like Android, for example, and it doesn't really use a lot of battery life, especially because it just sort of goes into a low power mode and sort of goes down to 1 hertz, which makes a lot of sense for an iPhone 13, where it could control the actual speed of the display, just like they do with the watch and the always on display. So it kind of fades and allows it to use very minimal battery, but still give you information. So that makes a lot of sense. Also, it's said that the control center is going to get an overhaul. Now, this concept looks exactly what I would think it would be like, being that this looks more like macOS. So last year, Apple updated macOS with macOS Big Sur, redesigned the control center, and it's said that the iPhone and iPad will get an updated control center. This sort of design makes a lot of sense if Apple continues sort of to bring them together and make them more consistent across all devices. So this seems to be what I would think. They would do something along these lines. I don't think we'll see a turn off button, as Apple doesn't really like to have the phone shut down. So, but we could see things like Wi-Fi looking like this, for example. Also, we could have a redesigned home app. Now, some people have hinted at this, where it would be more functional, it would be easier to use. I would welcome something like this, where it would show me the different devices I have, their state of battery, such as AirPods, MacBook Pro, Apple Watch. All of those things would be really nice to see. So we could see something like this, but it's hard to say if Apple will actually do that. And then, of course, most people want split screen multitasking. Now, this concept seems to make the most amount of sense. We have split view on the iPad. So on the iPhone, it would look something like this, where we'd have the option to expand it, close it, or maybe close all. I know a lot of people want that button. Apple doesn't really want you to close all the apps, because you don't normally need to unless there's a problem. It manages that in the background, except for maybe navigating apps where you need to close it so it doesn't work anymore when you're not using it. But other than that, this looks pretty much what it would look like. And if you expanded it, you could slide up and down just like you can on the iPad. That makes a lot of sense. So I think we'll see something like that. It makes a lot of sense on an iPhone to have split view. So hopefully we'll see that also. Now on the iPad, we've had this sort of home screen layout for quite some time. It seems to limit the amount of space you can use, and it's sort of a waste of space. And we also have widgets as well. According to Mark Gurman, iPad is going to get the biggest overhaul to its home screen since the launch of the iPad. So it looks like we'll be able to place widgets wherever we want, arrange them however we want. It could look something like this, where we'd be able to rearrange widgets any way we'd like, have a whole screen just of widgets or just of apps, or maybe more tightly together, maybe larger, or maybe something completely new we haven't thought of. But it looks like Apple is going to overhaul the home screen of the iPad to make it more functional. Also, it would have a redesigned control center, similar to what I showed you on the iPhone. It would just be on the iPad. It makes a lot of sense, instead of having this control center, to have maybe something a little bit different, similar to macOS, again, bringing that consistency across different platforms. Now, as far as apps, Pro apps seem to make a lot of sense. Now, whether or not Apple brings Final Cut Pro, this icon, to the iPad is hard to say. We've been waiting for it for years, but with the new M1 iPad Pro coming out, it seems like a waste of power without Pro apps. Final Cut Pro, Logic Pro, those sorts of things make a lot of sense on this sort of device if it's running an M1 and is that powerful. And then also, new icons. I think making icons consistent across devices makes a lot of sense. These are icons off of macOS Big Sur. Now, whether or not these are final designs or not, I know these are sort of something a lot of people don't like. I grew used to them using macOS Big Sur, but I wouldn't mind them being slightly refined or tweaked a little bit. So maybe we'll see some of that, again, to bring consistency. I also would expect possibly updates to multiple user accounts, and that could look something like this. Now, we do have this if you're an educational institution, but you could have multiple user accounts where you could switch between a family iPad, for example, just by tapping, having it scan your face if you have a Face ID iPad or your thumbprint or fingerprint, and switching between to have customized sort of home screens and things like that make a lot of sense. We have that on tvOS already, so why not bring it to iPad? So hopefully we see something like that, and it seems to make a lot of sense that bringing the consistency across different devices, as well as stability and maybe even a new settings pane as well. That's another thing that's sort of rumored, that we would have an all new settings pane with more helpful sort of settings and easier to reach settings. I would actually like to see settings brought into apps, consistently, maybe under one button. But right now, this is what we have. We've had it for years. It's also said that we'll get some new apps, some new app redesigns as well. We got some of that with iOS 14. I think we'll see more of it this year. But I think most people want split view. I would like a redesigned control center and much more. So let me know what you'd like most in the comments below. But as far as when to expect iOS 15, iOS 15 beta 1 should be out usually the same day as WWDC. So they'll announce the new features, show them off, and then they'll release the developer beta. Usually a couple weeks after that, they'll release public beta 1 along with developer beta 2. Usually that's what they do. Sometimes they wait for beta 3 as well with the developer betas, depending on its stability. Generally, it's pretty unstable right away. So we'll see that. And then we'll see a final release in September, usually around late September when the iPhone releases. So the third week of September is usually likely around the Friday, the 24th, for example. That's probably around the time Apple will release iOS 15 to the public. So I can't wait to see what they have. This makes a lot of sense, and I can't wait to see all of these features, what they do, what they change up, maybe give more interactive widgets as well. But those are all just wants at this point. There's no 100% guaranteed anything until we see it released from Apple, as they could change this at any last minute. Even the devices they support, they could change. So again, let me know what you want to see most in iOS 15 in the comments below. And if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.